Hi everyone. So in this video we'll discuss about the next Mendelian disorder, that is hemophilia as well as color blindness. So here these Mendelian disorders are where the recessive gene is being located on the X chromosome. So in the previous videos we had discussed about the recessive genes present on that of the autosomes, either it may be in the chromosome number 12 or it may be 11, or cystic fibrosis where the autosomal recessive gene disorder where the recessive gene is present on chromosome number 7. Okay, so those were there where the recessive gene were present on the autosomes. So in this video we'll discuss about the recessive genes present on the X chromosome. So the first one is hemophilia, which is also called as Royal's disease, also referred to as Bleeder's disease, and as it was being discovered by John Otto, it is also being named as Otto's disease. Now, first of all, what is this, why this hemophilia is being called as Royal's disease? Because this hemophilia was being the first case reported in that of the Queen Victoria family, thereby it has been regarded as Royal's disease. And why it is being referred as Bleeder's disease? Because an individual who is suffering from the hemophilia, okay, he lacks the platelet factors, either it may be the factor number 8 or 9 or even 11. So thereby the clotting, the process of clotting will be delayed. So thereby the individual continuously bleeds out. Thereby the name Bleeder's disease. And this hemophilia was being discovered by John Otto in the year 1803. So thereby the name is also being given as Otto's disease. So hemophilia is said to be a sex-linked or an X-linked disease. And in this, there is absence of the platelet factor, okay, and the various of the platelet factors which are being involved in that of the blood coagulation, when they are absent, so that results into three different types of the hemophilia. The first one is hemophilia A. So hemophilia A occurs when an individual lacks a factor 8, which is also called as an anti-hemophilic globulin. So when this factor 8 is absent in an individual, okay, so the individual will suffer from hemophilia A, which is being the very commonest type of the hemophilia, where nearly around 85% of the individuals suffering from the hemophilia are lacking with that of the factor 8. Next is hemophilia B. So this hemophilia B occurs due to the absence of the factor 9, which is also called as plasma thromboplastin factor, or it is even called as a Christmas factor. It is even called as Christmas factor. So why it is being regarded as Christmas factor? Because the first patient who had the hemophilia B was Christmas. So thereby it is being named after his identification. Thereafter we have hemophilia C. So hemophilia C occurs due to the absence of factor 11. So when these factors are being lacking or absent in an individual, any one of them, okay, then they will suffer with the respective hemophilia disease. So here hemophilia B is being seen around 15% of the individuals suffering from hemophilia, and hemophilia C is said to be a very rare, where it will be seen in 1%. If an individual suffers from hemophilia, he may have a chance of getting hemophilia C also, but it is rare when compared to that of the hemophilia A and hemophilia B. Now this particular disease, hemophilia, exhibits crisscross inheritance or zigzag inheritance, which means the recessive gene, if it is being present in that of a female, from the female, that recessive gene is inherited to the son, and from the son to his daughter. Okay, that is crisscross. And frequency of hemophilia is being 1 in 7,000 in that of the human males. That is frequency, you see here, 1 in 7,000 males it is there, and 1 in around 1 crore or 100 lakhs. So that is being seen in that of the females. So chances of female suffering from hemophilia is lesser when compared to that of the human males, which means males are affected more than that of the females. Right. Now here, hemophilic male is being denoted by that of the letter H, a smaller H. Okay. So if an individual has a recessive gene for the hemophilia, so in the male it is there like X, H, small h and Y. And in females, you see here, if there is presence of one recessive allele for the hemophilia, then that individual is said to be a carrier female. And if a female has both the recessive alleles, okay, then she will be regarded as a hemophilic female. Okay, so there is an interesting point here that the hemophilic females are generally not being born. That is due to a particular condition which happens, that when a hemophilic female is being there in that of the embryonic stage or during the fetal stage, okay, so there the possibility is that this kind of female who is having two recessive alleles, so that inhibits the synthesis of the RBCs, thereby these hemophilic females die during the infancy itself, which means they are not being born. Right. Now, here we have three conditions, how the recessive that allele will be inherited from one generation to the next generation. So let us see here, for example, when a hemophilic male, okay, affected hemophilic male, when he marries to that of a normal female, so what will happen? You can see that what is the chances of their progeny being affected and what is the chances of their progeny being normal. So that we look after here. So XH and X, so XH, X, and thereafter is XH, X. And here you can see that XY and XY, which means you can see that the daughters, if they are being born to such parents, so these daughters will be regarded as the carriers. Now already I had explained about why the females are being, if the female is having one recessive allele, then why these females are being regarded as carriers, because the other X chromosome has the dominant allele which suppresses the activity of the recessive allele, thereby the female, okay, is being the carrier if she has only one recessive allele. Whereas in that of the male, if a male has only one recessive allele for the hemophilia, the Y does not has the similar type of the dominant allele, so thereby the males are being affected. Right. So for these parents, if the daughters or the females are being born, they are generally carriers, whereas the males are normal. So there is no chance of the individuals being affected. So if a question is being asked in a competitive part, that if a hemophilic male marries to that of a normal female, then what is the chance of them having affected individuals? So then it will become 0%. Okay, right. Now next one is, when a normal male marries to that of a carrier female, so here what we can see is X and XH, X, H, X, both are same. Thereafter is XX, and next is XHY and XY. Okay, so here the first, you can see here the female, so this is a carrier female, a carrier female. Next is the normal female, normal female. She does not have any recessive allele, so she is normal. Whereas the male, you can see he has one recessive allele for the hemophilia, so he becomes the affected individual. So hemophilic males, and the last one is normal male. Okay, so whenever a normal male marries to a carrier daughter, so the chances of their progeny becoming affected with hemophilia is around 25%. Okay, so here the type of question which can be asked differs. So for example, among the four affected individuals are how many? It is only one, which means 25% of the progeny will be affected. Now if the question is how many of the males are being affected, means how many of their sons are being affected, it is 50%, because we have to consider only the males, because the question itself is being asked in such a way that how many of their sons are affected. So at that time it becomes 50%. How many are carriers? So among the four, okay, it is only one, so that becomes 25%. How many are normal? So it is 50%. Okay, one male and one female, one son and one daughter, so they do not have that recessive allele, so thereby they are said to be normal individuals. Now in the third case, if a hemophilic male marries to a carrier daughter, so here you can see that XH, okay, thereafter is XH and X, and next is XHY, and the last one is XY. So here you can observe that the girl, okay, where she is having two recessive alleles, so she becomes the affected female or the hemophilic female. Okay, and here you can see there is presence of one recessive allele, so this is carrier female, and the third one is the affected male or hemophilic male. Okay, and the last one you can see that is a normal male. So here the affected individuals are 50%. Affected individuals are 50%. One daughter, one son, so both are affected. And this daughter, okay, so as I said already, that whenever a female has two recessive alleles for the hemophilia, such females will die during infancy. So this female will die during infancy itself. Okay, thereafter is the percentage of affected daughters will be only 50%, because the other 50% are carriers. Affected sons are 50%. Other 50% are normal individuals. Okay, so based on the results, you need to understand or analyze the question which is being given. Okay, so that is very, very important for your NEET. So for example, if the question is being twisted in the form like that, where in a generation where females are either hemophilic or carriers, and males are either affected or normal, what is the genetic constitution of that of their parents? If that is being asked, so there you can have this affected male marrying to that of the carrier female. So this can be asked. So in your competitive exams, either the results will be given and they will ask for the parental chromosomal complement, or if the chromosomal complement of the parents is being given, and they will ask about the conditions or the results of the progeny or the F1 generation, right? So this is how that the hemophilia is, that particular recessive allele for the hemophilia is being inherited from one generation to the next generation. So here you can notice that if a father is having the recessive allele for hemophilia, then it is being inherited to the carriers, that is the female. So here it is being inherited. Now if this female gets married to a normal male, then that recessive allele, you can see that it is inherited to the son. It is even inherited to the daughter, but it is not affecting in the daughter, but the individual affected will be the males. So from the male to female, female to male. That is why I said it exhibits crisscross inheritance. The next one is the similar kind of the sex-linked recessive gene disorder. So that is called as color blindness. So color blindness, or it is also called as red-green color blindness, which was being discovered by Horner in the year 1876. So this particular X-linked recessive gene disorder is where the individual is unable to identify the red, green as well as the blue color, and all these three colors appears to them as gray. Now if an individual is unable to identify red, then that condition is called as protonopia. Protonopia, unable to identify red color. Deuteronopia, deuteronopia, where an individual is unable to identify green color. And tritonopia, tritonopia is where an individual is unable to identify the blue color. So that is the conditions, okay, in an individual, depending upon which color he is unable to or she is unable to identify. So similar kind, if there is presence of one recessive allele, here it is C, then that is a carrier female. Here you can see that one recessive allele in the male, colorblind male, and two recessive alleles, then that will be the colorblind female. One common thing what you have to remember here is, when in the hemophilia, if a female is having two recessive alleles, then these individuals will not survive. They die during infancy. Whereas if a female is having two recessive allele, whereas in that of the color blindness, if a female has two recessive alleles, then that female is being confined to that of the color blind. So she is regarded as a colorblind female. So that is not true with that of the hemophilic females. As I said, that hemophilic females, okay, who has two recessive alleles die during infancy. Okay, so next is what we can see is, forever there are four conditions where we can predict that their next generation, that is their progeny, will be having the color blindness or not. So that we'll discuss here. So for example, if a hemophilic male, sorry, if a colorblind male marries to that of a normal female, so what is that probability of the children having color blindness? So let us see. So XC and X, so XC and X, okay, so thereafter is again XC and X. So here in both the cases you are able to see that the daughters born to these parents will be having the recessive allele, but they are not being suffering from the color blindness, which means they are the carrier daughters. And the males, the produced, if the males are being produced and both the males are said to be the normal individuals. So here you can see that the recessive allele from the father is being inherited to the daughter, where daughter will become now a carrier. Now for example, if this carrier daughter marries to that of a normal male, so what will happen? So here it is XC and X, and thereafter is XX, thereafter is XCY and XY. So here you are able to see that among the four individuals, only one individual is affected, which means 25% of their generation will be affected when a carrier daughter marries to the normal male, and 25% okay of the individuals will be carriers, and 50% of the individuals will be normal, means they won't suffer from the color blindness. So here this individual where a female is having one recessive allele, so she becomes a carrier daughter. Now next one is the normal female, and thereafter is the color blind male, and the last one is a normal male. Okay, right. In the third case, if you look after, is here when a color blind male marries to that of a carrier daughter. So what is the probability or the percentage of the individuals getting or affected with that of the color blind? So here this is XC and XC, 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 thereafter is XCX, next is XCY, and the last one is XY. So here you are able to see that the among the females, okay, born to these parents, 50% of the females will be color blind and 50% will be the carrier daughters. Among the male, 50% of the males will be affected, so they are color blind males, and 50% are said to be the normal males. So here you are able to see that affected individuals are 50% and the normal individuals are 50%, where carrier daughters, although they have the recessive allele, but they never exhibit the color blindness, and that recessive allele will be inherited to the next generation. Whereas if both the parents, father as well as mother, if both the parents are color blind, then all the progeny born to these parents will be color blind. So that is XC and XC, thereafter is again XC, XC, XCY, and last one is also XCY. So 100% of the individuals will be suffering from color blindness. So both the females are color blind females and both the males are color blind. Okay, so as already told that color blindness is associated with only the vision, where an individual is unable to distinguish the colors such as red, green, as well as blue. So if a person is unable to identify the red color, then is called as protonopia. If an individual is unable to identify green color, the condition is deuteranopia. And if an individual is unable to identify blue color, then it is regarded as tritonopia. So this is all the video which is very, very important for the various of the competitive exams. And based on this, every year one or the other question will be asked either in that of the CET or it will be in that of the NEET. So this is the video where we had discussed all about the hemophilia, which is a bleeder's disease where an individual continuously bleeds. So that is, if an individual, if a normal individual, if he gets a minor cut, within a minute the clotting will take place. But in the individual who is suffering from hemophilia, may take hours together for the repairing of that minor injury. If this individual meets an accident, then due to heavy bleeding, that individual will die on the particular spot itself. So that is, hemophilia as well as the color blindness, both are the sex linked recessive gene disorders, and both these disorders will exhibit the zigzag inheritance. And where you can see that the males, if they have one recessive allele, so the males are said to be affected, whereas in the females, if a female has a recessive allele on the X chromosome, then the female is being regarded as a carrier but never exhibits the symptoms or the disease. And by chance, if a female has two recessive alleles on the X chromosome, then those females are said to be affected. Thank you.